All right. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the first Acoustic Sundays of the semester. I'm just going to read a quick disclaimer for you guys. Suffolk Free Radio, Boston Radio, the views and opinions expressed on WSFR Acoustic Sundays are the views and opinions of the on-air personalities only. These views do not reflect those of Suffolk University, Suffolk Free Radio, or those of the Student Leadership and Involvement Office. All right, and so with that out of the way, today I'm here with Joby. That's it, all capital letters. we're gonna do an interview. We're gonna play some music. Mm-hmm. We're gonna kick off the semester to a good start. So let's just get right into it. So I guess I'll just ask you some basic questions.
Yeah, go for it.
Your musical style. How would you describe it?
I would say that I guess I'm kind of folky and rootsy, but also very pop oriented, like pop melodies with a folk flair. I also try to play a lot of music that's very emotionally gratifying, if that makes sense. Yeah.
How much after your own like personal life do you say your music or your songwriting pulls from?
100% of
100%.
It. Well, no, actually some of it is based off of mythology or like books that I was reading, but most of it is about me. Or even if it is like about something else, or if it's by way of something of like if I'm using a particular metaphor in one of my songs, it'll still sort of tie back
right
to me.
But because I know a lot of folk songwriters or traditional songwriters tend to sort of like pull from like a random other people's stories or like make up a story entirely, and then but I guess your music is more just based off of your own personal experience.
Yep, or at least that's like the music I probably choose to promote most of the time,
right?
Because it's the music I feel the best playing. Because I don't know. I know that even though I wrote it, it still feels cathartic to me to play it.
Uh-huh. And you mentioned earlier to me that you have music out on streaming platforms.
Yeah, I do.
I mean, I guess what kind of material you have up there already? What's on there, really?
Yeah. So I've been releasing music now for I think like almost two years.
Nice.
But I only have 5 songs out that I've released. All as singles.
All as singles.
My first song, it's called Halfway. It's a song about, I think, just past relationships I've had and my relationship to how I feel about people. I don't know. That was like my first song. And then I have another song called Scorpio, and they're all kind of moody, sad songs. I released a song a few months ago, and that's actually more of a pop song that I produced with my friend from Emerson. But most of the stuff actually on there is I just produced it myself.
Sick.
Aside from that.
So that's really cool. How long have you been at this like music thing in general? Like, when did you start playing? And then when did you get to the point where you're like, okay, I'm ready to release stuff on streaming services?
I don't even know. Like, I have been I played ukulele and stuff, and I would write songs on ukulele when I was like, since I was around 11.
Wow.
But I never did it very seriously, and I always thought of it as a hobby or like a side thing. But when I was a little kid, I would make up songs in my head before I could play anything. And then over quarantine, I could play guitar a little bit before then, but I really started practicing guitar and writing more songs more frequently. And then after COVID got a little bit better, I tried to go to a bunch of open mics or get any kind of performance that I could possibly get. And now I've just been trying to do that still.
Well, I mean, location-wise, you go to Emerson. Mm. You live in Boston, right?
Yeah, I just moved off campus to Cambridge. I was living in the dorms at Emerson for the past 2 years, but
how is that on the music scene? Do you
It's cool.
Does it impact you at all in terms of playing or writing or anything? Or
I kind of have this small community of people in Cambridge who I play music with and around. Like, I met some stand-up comedians, and they do these small shows at different venues.
That's
then they
fun.
Get me to, or they get I know this one guy who gets musicians to open.
That's so cool.
For the show, so he hires me a lot. That's cool. So, and it's all in Cambridge, so that's a plus of living there. But also, I try to do stuff not only in Cambridge, like in Boston proper.
Yeah, so I assume, yeah, you obviously you release music under your own, like, little moniker. You're mainly a solo performance artist, is that correct?
Yes, I was playing with, like, a band for a while, just for a few gigs that I had to do, I guess, last semester. But, yeah, I'm honestly probably most comfortable playing by myself. I don't know. I feel like I'm kind of a control freak.
Do you think if you're in an environment with like multiple collaborators, is that gonna like influence or change your sound in any way? And do you plan on ever like taking that like sort of step in the future? Or
oh, for sure, I hope to play with like a ton of people, hopefully like multiple musicians in the future. Yeah, I think it's just something that takes practice. It's something that's going to take practice for me to be more comfortable with it, because I can feel like I can be myself if I'm on stage, because there's nothing else. If I'm alone on stage, cause
right.
then there's nobody. I'm nobody else's, like, performance is riding on me. I'm not going to make anybody look bad.
It's all just you.
Because it's on me. But if I mess up and I'm playing with other people, or if they mess up, then like they make me look bad, I make them look bad, you know. But
band drama.
It just like takes practice for me to be comfortable.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's cool. So, and then you mentioned you're also working on music currently. So how's that going? What's that process like?
Yeah. So I've been like mastering, or I'm in the process of like mixing this EP, which I'm gonna release hopefully soon in the fall, in the later fall, maybe November. November? I don't
Ooh.
Know. Yeah, I'm working on mixing that right now. But oh, I'm also doing a ton of music videos.
Oh, sick!
Yeah, a lot of people at Emerson want to film stuff, so I'm taking advantage of
classic
that.
Classic Emerson students.
Mm-hmm.
So are you trying to do like a music video for every song or something, or like?
No, not for every song. Just like three of them.
Just for three. Still, that's a pretty hefty.
Yeah,
pretty hefty number.
I'm kind of scared that I'm kind of scared that I'm gonna get really burnt out. But it's fine.
I'm sure people at Emerson know what they're doing. I mean,
yeah, a lot of them. I've done music videos with people before at Emerson, and they were really good.
Have you made music videos for your songs before? Or?
Yeah, I have a music video on my YouTube right now for this song, one of the songs I released.
Then what's the YouTube channel called, just so people can find it?
Joby. J-O-B-I-E. But you could search, if you're looking for the music video specifically, you can search Joby All For One. That's the song that the music video is for.
Sick.
Yeah, J-O-B-I-E, like Josie, but with a B in it instead of an S.
Fantastic. So, yeah, so you're working on that, you're working on new music, you're mixing your music, and you're making videos for it, so it seems like it's coming along pretty decently.
Yeah, I'm just trying to play more shows, though, out. Mm-hmm. What I've been doing lately is I've been going to a lot of friends and acquaintances' shows.
Yeah.
I think that, I don't know, you can't expect everybody to come to your shows if you don't go to other people's shows. So.
You scratch my back, I'll scratch yours.
Yeah, well, I think that's just, I mean, there's a lot of good that can come from that, though, too. Like, I could see somebody and learn from them,
right,
and enjoy their music and listen to their story.
it seems like you're very immersed in the sort of community that should definitely help, I think.
Yeah, I'm trying to be.
That's very cool. All right, and then just any idea what you're going to play for us today, that sort of thing, or?
Yeah, I'll probably play a mixture of things I've released and things that I am yet to release soon. Do you want me to like say the title of the song?
You can do whatever you want. If you want to, leave it in suspense. If you want to tell a little story or explain how the song is, you can do whatever you'd like.
Word. And then how much time do I have?
Like around half an hour or something.
Okay, yeah, be like.
All right, so yeah, I guess without further ado, well. you're free to play your set.
Yeah, okay.
You're ready for that.
I was wondering if you were going to sit there the whole time. But the, like, I wouldn't mind. But it would just be cool. This song is called All for One. This is the one that I have the music video for. So if you like this song, look it up on YouTube. Maybe I just like the idea of loving you. She's sitting on the counter with her cowboy boots, looking of dread, with a red beam that is gleaming from her head. My baby, don't my one for Okay, that was the first song. Thanks, live studio audience. Yeah, that song was called All for One. It was kind of more, that song was more about dreams that I've had and like a surreal experience and experiences that I've had with my friends, maybe when I didn't really sort of, I didn't know what was going on, and I tried to capture that in this sort of unhinged metaphorical language of the song. Anyways. That song is out on Spotify, all platforms, including Apple Music. It was a white lie. It was a white lie. That song's called Irish Goodbye, and that will be on my EP. That will be, like, one of the lead singles, I think. I'm making a music video for that one. It's going to involve animals, and the animals are going to be dancing around, and there's going to be, like, a food fight. Yeah. Are you... Never mind. In your hand. Yeah. No, I was just commenting on it. Sorry, I made it awkward. Also, I said a cuss word in that song. I forgot.
I'm sorry. No, you're good. Okay.
All right. I'll never be invited back to WSFR. Sorry. Thank you.
It's pretty simple when you think of it. I'm making faces in the mirror like a kid, kicking myself, remembering what happened. Tried to replay it like it didn't, but it did.
That song was called Cruel Vice. Thanks for the claps. Yeah! That one's also going to be on the EP. But I'm going to play a song that I have released now. I was talking about it before. It's called Halfway. Yeah, it's about multiple people in my life who are no longer in my life. Yeah. Thank you.
Once your soul made a match made in heaven, I told you I loved you, I told you I loved you. I make the same mistakes again and again. I live with my regrets. Don't want you to leave. Stay right here, don't leave. But you're halfway there. She used to say I counted everything. I counted on you. I used to think I ruined everything. I was doing what you told me. Oh.
yeah, that song is on Spotify. That was my first song I ever released. And I'm really proud of it, actually. I think when I initially release things, it's like, ew, gross. But then after a while, like a year, I'm like, that's good. It's not bad. Okay. I just went to Greece, and I just studied abroad. And when you leave the country, I feel like there's a perspective that's gained because you're literally just physically in another geographic space, another place in the universe. And then you have to think about yourself in relation to your home and yourself in relation to everything. And I wrote this song about the passage of time and also the patriarchy, which are connected, by the way. You don't have to clap every time. Thanks. I'm glad you guys are enjoying this music. And I know that somebody playing guitar and only guitar is not everybody's cup of tea all the time. And I think that it shouldn't be. You think? Okay. 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 So I'm lame? No, actually I love listening to people play guitar. Like that's No, I was being genuine. I love listening to people play guitar, but not everybody does. People I don't know. But I hope actually for my sake that people do love it. I hope that it's something that people love forever. Let me know how much time do I have? One more song. Okay. Yeah. For sure. No, it's not all right. I want to be here for 3 more hours. Only me. Wait. Oh yeah, I could play Scorpio. Cuz that's my hit song. But I got to play I don't know. Which one do you want? I was going to play like a newer song. That's more upbeat. Okay, I'm going to play the newer song. You can listen to my song Scorpio if you're a Scorpio and also if you're not a Scorpio on Spotify. But this song is going to be on my EP, and it's, I guess, up-tempo, but it's not a happy song. I don't know. But I also am making a music video for this, and I just had a GoFundMe on my Instagram to get people to give me money, because I don't have any money for the expenses of this. And me and the people producing it raised a bunch of money, and it was awesome. So thank you, people. Anyways.
If I lived under the earth and I was lost beneath the sea, oh, would you be the first to search or be the one to bury me? Oh,
I guess all I have for you, thank you so much, Suffolk University, WSFR. This is, like, awesome. I love just playing music and chilling. And, yeah, thanks for watching the live.
This has been another episode of WSFR Acoustic Sundays. Make sure to tune in next time. This is Joby.
Hi.
Listen to her wherever you can. She's on all the streaming services. Mm-hmm. So without further ado, thank you for stopping by.
Thank you. All right. Yay.